just came back for the win. Lot of new money in my hand. Go on, tell a friend and tell a friend. They say success is the best revenge.
Yeah.
Turn me up.
Yeah. Hey, check it. Okay, I feel unstoppable. Losing's impossible. Go against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line, do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible. You ain't made it till you got stylists go out and shop for you. You ain't made it till they put on top of you. Parading through the city, the whole block come out for you. We just getting started, y'all finna see what we bout to do. Boy, stop, you ain't here, I'm the real truth. Hunters real blue, strips on them still new. Shopping at Dover Street, I'm dripping like mildew. They say you don't visit the hood, dog, I still do. A real one, only difference, my bill's bigger. I'm still with ya, I just got rich a little quicker. The same man, God handed me his game plan. I ain't perfect, far from it, what can I say, man? I feel unstoppable, losing's impossible. Go against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line, do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible. It felt like yesterday, I was just driving my grandma's Chevrolet. From South Carolina to Maryland, I take the jet today. I'm still on the come up, I'm still building my resume. I still got a lot to prove, but still I'm heavyweight. I still gotta watch my moves, they try to defamate my character, but I won't let them, it's always checkmate. I'm still screaming, the world hope she Mother Nature's my first shawty, watch how I go ballistic and I'm so terrific. Accounts is copacetic, I don't need no permission, but I'm so indebted to this game that I love, and most of all to the man above. Now check me out, now I was just that Fridays was serving the greens. Before I was popping, I was nursing my dreams. Now I ain't never been a gangster, but I know a few things. I just rather get the bag and start collecting the rings. But I done spoke too much, close curtain and scene. I am not a human being, I'm a full machine. I ain't holier than thou, I don't judge, I seen. Just staying down for the come up till I reign supreme. Let's get it. Yeah, hit boy, we got another one. Ha! Man, y'all boys ain't ready for this, man. I'm still grinding, I'm still hungry, hungrier than ever. I feel unstoppable, losing's impossible. Go against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line, do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible.
Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to the desert southwest, Glendale, Arizona, and State Farm Stadium. Tonight we continue with Wild Card Weekend with what should be a great one between the Carolina Panthers and the Arizona Cardinals. Winner go home is the mantra, and off we go. We're underway in this NFC Wild Card game. This is taken way up at the 25. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. They'll start on the ground, it's Derrick Henry. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. That's a gain of 13 and a very solid opening play for this offense. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, where that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Ready,
They keep it with Henry on first down. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Play action. It's Montana. He's got a man complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A gain there of 30 big ones. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Henry running right. And he is in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Derrick Henry, 26 yards. And the Cardinals will strike first here in this wild card matchup. Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. From the 10. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. Set up first and 10, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
The last run good for 2. Here's second and 8. Play action. It's Warner. Airing this one out for Evans. And got his man complete. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33.
Big plays always wind up being a big theme as we get rolling these playoffs. And the defenses that can avoid giving them up, but they're the teams that tend to go far. You may not eliminate those big plays, but if you can limit them, then you've got a chance to get to the ultimate game.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. 12 more yards there and another first down.
Good running right there. And this is a man who was a 1,000-yard rusher in the regular season, so you know he's going to get his chances. And he picks up nice yardage on that one.
A play fake. Now Warner. Got it for a Panther touchdown. A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers are able to match the opening drive touchdown against them with one of their own. Charles, here in their opening series, they said they had certain plays scripted for certain players. That looked like a well-designed play to get one of their top targets involved.
Yeah, let's face it, Brandon, a player of his talent is a problem for any opponent to defend, and we saw it right there. They tried to deny an open lane to him. He still outplayed the coverage and scored the early touchdown. Good luck trying to figure out how to defend him as this game moves on.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. The offense coming back out here. Plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sideline, partner, knowing you just won the battle against the opposing defense. And since they came off the field, I'll guarantee you all they want to do is get back out there because they know they have the upper hand on that defense right now.
To throw again on second down. Montana throws right back to London, complete again. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
So a great throw right there, and what a regular season this rookie had, piloting this offense, guiding them to a division title, and they get the home date here in round one of the playoffs. But Charles, how do you think they'll play it here? Will they run the same kind of wide open offense they've run all season, or do you think that they'll try and take some pressure off of the young fella?
Oh, I think they're going high, wide, and handsome in this one. I think it's all out, just as they've been doing all year long, because I think if you try and pull it back now a little bit, you're telling that young man you don't have quite as much confidence in him as you've professed. So go ahead and continue to run your offense. Do the things that got you here. As so many defensive coaches have told you and me, all gas, no brakes. Let it rip.
In motion here is Witten. From the 16, Montana. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
They go play action with Montana. And it's caught. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And that could be one of those turning point plays in a ball game. A field goal gets you the lead here, but they want to make a statement and get 6 points. And they're certainly going to get that opportunity as they get the conversion and set up first and goal.
Going to go as a loss of one on first down. So they're backed up to the 3 yard line, second and goal.
It's a loss of one. Brings up second and goal at the 3 yard line.
Hey, hey, check that.
Henry again. And he is in for six. Touchdown, Cardinals. Derrick Henry with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Cardinals have taken the lead. Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. Looking for White on the deep ball. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. John Johnson with the INT. And the Cardinals are going to take possession of the football. So they try to take the deep shot there, but this defense up to the task.
And a lot of times when you air a ball out like this, if it does get intercepted, there's going to be a lot of space out there to set up a return. And remember, you've got five big offensive linemen out there playing on their feet in open space. Not a skill most of them possess that allows for extra yardage on the return.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. P. Play fake. Now here's Montana. He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone. Back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete. So a costly penalty yardage-wise as that'll move the football down to the spot of the foul.
And what the officials are looking for in these situations, whether you're playing the man or the ball. And if you're playing the man, you get a lot less leeway in terms of what's going to happen at the end of the play. But if you're looking for the football, it's less likely to draw the flag.
Trying to punch it in with Henry. Into a mass of bodies, and I think they held him out. They did. Call it no gain, and it's going to be second and goal.
They're right there at the one. No gain, but don't let that stop you. Line back up and keep going at them. If I'm them, I'm thinking about going at it four straight times.
They'll try again, and he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. So what a first half that he has had running the football. That now three touchdown runs.
And I would anticipate that when they get down in the red zone, he's going to get more chances as this game goes on. And I think that the guys blocking for him are going to ask for him to get more chances. They like the rhythm they've developed.
Extra point by Simon, up and good. And it's now 21-7. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And the Cards are going to take over at their own 41. And, Charles, you know, it seems like sometimes when you fall down early, there can be a tendency there to try and get it all back in one fell swoop. And that time, that thinking leads to an interception.
And I believe you brought up a really good point there, Brandon, because you try and force plays, right? You try and get all back in one shot, just as you mentioned there. And you know you're going to need some big plays to get back into the game. But ultimately, you really can't force what isn't there.
On second and 11 now, Montana. This pass is caught by London. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. And that'll be a free 5 yards for the offense.
Just like a tennis match, that's just an unforced error. Stay alert, don't jump early, and give them free yardage.
So a first and 5 now after the 5-yard penalty from the neutral zone infraction. They'll try the right side with Henry. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Touchdown, Cardinals! Henry on his way to a historic performance, 4 first half touchdowns. And the Cards continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. Fields this way up at the 17, and he won't quite make it to the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They trail early on the road in the playoffs. Not a great combination as they've got it first and 10. Now a throw here to his running back. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It'll be Warner on first down. time here in this half. It's intercepted. Picked off by A.J. Terrell. And the Cardinals are going to take possession of the football.
A nightmare of a first half for him. That's now three interceptions. But Charles, with his talent, if anyone can shake this off and right the ship, it's him.
I agree, because you don't get to be one of the best quarterbacks in the league without developing some major mental toughness. So I expect him to go in the locker room at halftime, hit the reset button, and come out a new guy in half number two.
First and 10 for Montana and Company. Here's Johnson with a reception. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
Well, you don't have to be a genius to watch this game and figure out they've had plenty of success moving the football here in the first half. We've seen exhibits A, B, C, and right on down the line, haven't we?
Yeah, we just saw exhibit Z right there.
A first down carry for Henry. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Well, partner, they've been running it well the entire game, and the big guys up front, they're a huge reason why. And now they're reaping the benefits as they continue to open up big holes and gain nice yardage.
Second down, they go again with Henry. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive, not much since. They will look to throw. Montana. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. Cole Kmet from 13 yards out. And the Cardinals continue to pull away here in this first half. Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And a rout is on here in this first half. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. Fields this way up at the 17. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, and this is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated. I like the calmness of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand, and that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
Here's Warner. Going up top. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by John Johnson. And the Cards are going to get the football here at their own 40-yard line.
Well, that is interception number 4 for him, Charles. 4 here in the first half alone. And they're already trailing by 4 possessions.
Makes me wonder, partner, do they just not have any confidence at all in the backup, or do they just have that much confidence in him? Able to throw 4 picks already, they're certainly hoping that he can turn things around and quickly.
And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
second and nine. Montana, a quick throw, knocked away and incomplete.
The quarterback got away with one there. Looked like he was in line for a pick, but instead is knocked harmlessly to the turf.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. Johnson, the man in motion right. Here's Montana to throw. Looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. And the Panthers are going to take possession of the football. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Looking for White on the deep ball. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
Well, certainly they haven't had the ideal first half, but there's something, some momentum for them to take into halftime.
Yeah, and it might not be that wild momentum, you know, that you see sometimes when they score late and teams go sprinting off and the whole deal. No, it might not be that, but it does give them a better feeling about themselves and what they can accomplish in the second half.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard battle. Fields this way up at the 17. And he returns this to the 22. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And Charles, that had to be an interesting locker room at halftime. This is a team that's had so much success this year. Haven't really had to deal. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Carolina. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. From just inside the 20, a short kick. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
You could say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime, then sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
From the 35 on second down, Montana. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. Montana. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
Well, partner, they went empty set there. No backs in the backfield. all receivers out in the pattern. And in this situation, you know what the quarterback has to do? Act as his own blitz control.
Yeah, he's got nobody else there to protect.
No one else there to protect, which means he's got to get rid of the football and absorb the hit, but not go down and fumble the ball.
Following the fumble recovery, Warner. And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
Well, they certainly knew their challenge as this series began, and they got a stop on play number one. Goal now, get two more stops and limit the damage to a field goal.
Order to throw. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And the Cardinals are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line.
I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw a second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now five times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent. But a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ballgame, I would have said never. Not in a million years, but here we go. On first down, Montana. Throw left side, complete. That's Henry. And some room to work.
And he will step out of bounds here inside the 30.
A big play there on the catch and run. 51 yards. So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. Again to Henry.
133 yards rushing for him now as he has been a central figure in trying to get his guys to the second round.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
They'll try and run for it with Henry. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
And now defensively, you have to look at this like the game's on the line. It's just the third quarter, but another touchdown given up here could really spell an end to their chances, so they need to toughen up and keep them out of the end zone.
And the busy night for Henry continues. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Derrick Henry, a 5-yard touchdown run.
And the Cardinals have moved out in front by 3 touchdowns. He finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. 3 downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns in 21.
Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. Fields this way up at the 17. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get 2 more possessions.
On first and 10, Warner. This is caught by Evans. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Warner. Touchdown, Panthers. Mike Evans, 28 yards. And the Panthers get a bit closer. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead will be cut down to 14. Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. From just inside the 20, a short kick. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. Their lead down from 21 to 14, but still sitting in a great spot, up two scores here in the third quarter. And this is going to be a Cardinals first down as good running gets him to about the 44. He continues to have a big night here under the lights carrying the football.
And some guys prefer night games for whatever reason. Their bodies react a certain way. They love the spotlight. Maybe that's what it is. The best seats in the house, the ones where he's carrying the football for his offensive teammates. The worst seats, the 11 guys trying to tackle him on defense.
And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line. How about Jonathan Allen there pushing upfield to make the stop behind the line? Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Now Montana. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Dropped for a loss of 7 by multiple defenders.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Looking for 19 yards here on third down following two negative plays. In motion here is Witten. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them because they know that they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
A very nice punt that time, but they get 11 back on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. If they want to advance in this divisional round, look, obviously the time is now. Trailing here in the fourth as they go to work on a... He's got a man complete! And he's going to get this down near the 25. Quite a show of arm strength right there. That was in the air for a long time, and it was on target, too. First down throw, Warner. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
It's nothing like pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left, contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now Warner. Ebron with it over the middle. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. So three plays already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. Tomlinson is into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Well, time to let those folks know who are tuning in looking for the late local news. We may be a moment because we've got a game again.
And partner, except for those on the West Coast, where it'll be seen in its regular time, right? That's the way it works, doesn't it? But how about that big-time drive right there? If they're going to have any chance, they needed a touchdown there, and they went right down the field and worked their way into the end zone.
This is taken way up at the 25. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And this, a very important drive leading to the fourth quarter of this wild card game. But this one far from over as they start out here first down. The tackle is made by Micah Hyde.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for four-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. And the Panthers are going to take possession of the football. Well, holding on to the lead at this stage in the second half, those are the types of plays you really want to try and stay away from.
And when you're a rookie, keeping your focus is something that you still have to work on all the time because there's so many distractions around you between the crowd noise and your coaches and your teammates. But the other part, you've got to learn how to finish. It's the two F's for a rookie quarterback.
To throw, Warner. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. A great effort there with his second touchdown of the night. And the Panthers are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This is taken way up at the 25. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. And it's all on the line now, all even in this wild card matchup. Maybe their most important drive of the season coming up right now here, first and 10. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down of the sack. To try again after the sack. Montana. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
They certainly thought they had him surrounded and probably thought they were going to get him on the ground and get the sack, but he was able to elude that. And even though it threw it incomplete downfield, if you're a defensive back, you're loving the pressure that you're seeing from your front.
To throw is Montana. And this is going to be intercepted. And the Panthers are going to take possession of the football. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think, okay, he's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay. Oftentimes, when you see a running back get bunched up in the backfield, it's usually because the defensive tackle is eating up blockers for others to make the play. Not in this case.
On second down, Warner. Ebron caught left side. And he'll be brought down at the 27.
And partner, in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars. And he came through with a nice catch right there.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. Now Warner. Swinging this ball out here to Tomlinson. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. Nothing open downfield. They went underneath.
Yeah, see if you can get it to your running back. See if you can make someone miss in the open field.
Options galore here. Second and a few inches. To throw. Warner. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. There have been quite a few plays they might look back on and say, we really have hurt ourselves, and that was another example.
And this is late game execution. Everything on the line, so it all has to come together properly. The throw's made. Where's the catch? Gotta catch in that spot.
They'll look for the first with Tomlinson. And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11.
A nice run right there. And we talk this time of year about certain teams, certain players who don't have a lot of postseason history to speak of. And here's a man right here in his rookie season in the NFL, and he's being asked to carry the load at running back for this offense.
And he has acquitted himself nicely here in his rookie year. And look, I think we both believe that the burden's a little lighter on backs and receivers than it is on quarterbacks in the playoffs. But that's not to say this is going to be easy. As fast as the NFL game is in the regular season, it's like warp speed when you turn pressure up in the postseason. So let's see how he handles things early.
Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. On second down, it's Tomlinson. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. The eighth play of the drive coming up. It's third and three. They'll try and pick it up with Tomlinson. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown of the night. And the Panthers have broken our tie and have taken a fourth quarter lead. Point after, right down the middle. And they will take a 7-point lead. Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. This is taken way up at the 25. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. At their own 33-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we'll lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Now that's two big catches that he's had on this drive alone.
And I can hear it right now. If they give up a third to him, Whoever does that, go stand on the other sideline. You're persona non grata on our team at that point.
They'll try again here from the 7 on 2nd and goal. In motion here is Whitten. Back to throw. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. This pass rush, they've been excellent all game long, and another example of it right there in the closing moment.
Not only with the pass rush, but how well they're coached, because if you don't quite get there, get to the quarterback, get your hands up into the passing lane and knock it away, as we just saw there.
They'll look to throw. And this ball is caught. It's a touchdown. And now in the final seconds, they're a PAT away from likely getting this thing to overtime. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we may very well be headed to overtime. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter.
From the 10.
Oh, a good return up past the 30. And great field position coming up as he gets this just shy of the 45, out of bounds at the 44.
Well, so much for the worry about how they would be after losing their lead. What a big-time return to seize the momentum back.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Tie game, probably time for one final play here. What do you do in this spot?
Now you're thinking about Hail Mary. You've got to find a way to heave it all the way towards the end zone and give yourself a chance. Your time management sheet tells you with this amount left on the clock.
And that's caught inside the 30. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. And we have free football overtime. Here we go, my friend.
And the way this game played out, this is exactly how it should end, going to overtime, because neither one got an advantage today.
Chills and thrills in this one, and more to come here as overtime will decide who moves on to the divisional round. Taken at the 15, a short kick, and he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And CD, we get to see the debut of the brand new postseason overtime rules. Now, as everybody is learning, both teams are going to be guaranteed an offensive possession. So they might get the ball first here, but a touchdown does not right away win the game.
And we saw many marker games along the way that sparked a lot of conversation. But the Buffalo Kansas City game in the 2022 playoffs, that really brought about this rule change. What an amazing game, a true classic. Ended in overtime without Buffalo getting a shot with the football, and the people didn't like that at all. So starting this season, if you make the playoffs, you'll get a chance to answer if the other team scores first, and that way you get a chance to keep a great game as well as your hopes alive as you chase the big prize.
Again, it's Tomlinson. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. 2nd down coming up. A 4-receiver set here. 3 to the left, 1 to the right, 2nd and 6. Now a first throw here in overtime. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Carolina. And Charles, that touchdown alone doesn't win him the game anymore with the rule changes and overtime of the postseason. But they still went down, scored, got the job done, and now they put it in the hands of their defense.
And with the other side now guaranteed an overtime possession, getting that score was vital. The pressure's now on their opponent, and their defense, they have to play off the momentum the offense generated. One stop, and they end this game.
Very short kick taken right at the 20. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started.
Well, CD, in the regular season, they would already be celebrating. Not so simple here in the playoffs. Now they also need to make a defensive stand if they want to pick up the victory.
Yeah, and I'm sure the team would be in favor of just taking the win right now, but in a small way, those defenders also kind of happy for the rule change, because now, on the big stage of postseason, they're the ones who can come out here and lock down the victory.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Letting one go deep for the end zone. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Partner, they've been aggressive airing it out all game long, and no better evidence than those last two snaps. They weren't going to beat this coverage, though, two plays in a row, and that one falls incomplete.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. So as they head to the sidelines, we'll head to this break on EA Sports. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Play fake. Now here's Montana. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Coverage was very good that time. A nice job to smother him as the ball arrived, and that ensured an incomplete pass.
And it keeps 6 points off the board.
Nervous time now, moving the chains, an absolute must. Here's third down.
Back to throw again. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. Running left, it's Henry. And he fights his way in, not giving up. And it's a Cardinal touchdown. 4 yards there on the touchdown run. Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that is going to tie up this ball game. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And a short kick taking it about the 16. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
Well, one touchdown answered by another, and we see those new overtime rules come into play and extend this game here, partner. So now it's nice and simple from here on out. Next score wins.
It certainly is, isn't it? Even with the new rules, this is why winning that opening coin toss is so valuable.
He's got a man complete.
And they're going to get this down to about the 37.
Offense just continues to reign supreme. Big plays, both sides, back and forth. Tough to keep track of.
It certainly is, and I'm over here just marveling at what I'm seeing. It's tough for you, though. You got to call all these big plays and have all this emotion each time they go at each other.
Airing this one out for Evans. And this is caught inside the five. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. And now this game's going to come down to the right leg of their kicker. This to advance to the divisional round. And the kick is good. He got it. And it's official now. They're going to the playoffs.
Well, Charles, you don't get many more games exciting than that. Not only did we reach overtime in the playoffs, but what a show it was once we got to OT.
And when those new overtime rules were put in place for the postseason, Brandon, I think everyone thought fairness first, but how about the byproduct of what we're seeing here? These types of games, incredibly entertaining. Everyone's on the edge of their seats, and in the end, both teams did get an opportunity in overtime. A huge win for them, and I think it's safe to say, one of the best games we'll see this entire postseason.